welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me today is Tom Thimot, CEO at authID. Tom, good to see you. How are you?
It's very nice to see you, Christine.
Tom, I first wanted to start off with some industry predictions for 2022. We did see authID recently publish a 2021 Fintech Security Report that showed that fintech and banking leaders may be worried about legacy authentication solutions and plan to invest more in newer solutions this year. So what do you think are kind of the main trends here that are driving demand?
You clearly see that fintech and banking leaders, 84% of them, are looking to make greater investments in identity verification and authentication. And we think that trend is going to really get realized in 2022. I think also you're going to see passwords become more and more obsolete. Not only are consumers and employees tired of trying to remember passwords, companies are more and more using the device that the person has to verify and authenticate them as opposed to just something they remember. And companies are dealing with a workforce that wants to stay remote. 51% of all employees across the country want to be remote. And if they want to be remote, you have to have a way to continually verify and authenticate them because they're not inside the walls of your own organization.
So from your vantage point, what do you think is the kind of the current state of the cybersecurity industry?
Cybersecurity industry is constantly being challenged. You look at major cyber breaches like SolarWinds and other incidents where clearly the password has become the weak link. And, cyber criminals don't hack into your account. They log in with passwords they've stolen or that they've figured out, or they understand how to answer challenge questions about you. And this is why the move to biometric authentication, verifying that it is me behind the device, not just my device, or that it's me and not just someone that knows my password that is actually carrying through the transaction. And so I think that's really critical. And finally, people want to understand that privacy is being respected. Recently, the IRS decided that they didn't really want to move forward with biometric authentication yet that was delivered by ID.me. And I think the mistake that company made is they talk a lot about facial recognition. And facial recognition is very spooky to the consumer and to the employee. Facial recognition is picking someone out of a crowd. The difference is facial matching, consented facial matching, where I know when I sign up and I allow you to have a picture of me, a representation of me, that it is only going to be used for the purpose of logging me in. It is not going to be used for any other purpose. No one's going to pick me out of a crowd. And having the ethical use of artificial intelligence and privacy that is not buried in the 25th page of terms and conditions, but is right in bold as you click in to take that selfie. I think that's what's really needed.
Given that, what is your sense of customer taste or needs right now?
Customers have become very comfortable with taking a selfie. And so many times a day, whether we're paying at the supermarket or other ways, we have become accustomed to using our smartphone and to look into it, and it authenticates us. The weak link is the fact that it autofills a password. But I think the step to get customers to say, I'm going to actually use my face to unlock my account and to complete my transaction, if it's messaged correctly and the UI is simple and it's not complicated. When you first set up Face ID on Apple, they make you turn your head 20 different directions before it acknowledges who you are. It has to be something quick. This is where the liveliness detection is so important. We get you to wink or to smile, something that shows your facial features, but at the same time ensures that it's not someone just holding up a photo of you or a video of you, that it actually really is you behind that selfie.
So for authID itself, give us a sense of what's next in terms of growth strategy and plans for 2022.
In 2021, we rebranded from Ipsity. We took a company that was a mile wide and an inch thick, but covered the entire spectrum of the identity verification landscape. and recognized that it had real differentiable intellectual property in one key area, which was this cloud-based biometric that could be used to unlock an account and provide an audit trail of who was accessing the account. So we focused everything on that product we called Verify. And now we are expanding that, and in multiple different trials with customers, from fintechs to banks to people in the medical profession, to verify that this is the best way to authenticate the consumer or the employee as they are doing their job or as they are interacting with your service. And we expect those proof of concepts to turn into engagements where consumers and employees alike have the option. I'm going to consent. I allow my face to be used. Wow, I see that is so much easier than other methods of authenticating. I don't need to remember a password. I don't need to go through an awful process when I get locked out of my account because I've forgotten my password. I just look into either a webcam or into my smartphone and the account unlocks because the liveness detection is there. It understands who I am. It uses very sophisticated biometric and artificial intelligence technologies to make sure that the person behind the transaction is me. And we expect that to really get us market momentum because the market is moving away from passwords and biometrics are the end state that we all know that who we are is more important than what we may have in our hand or something we remember like a password. And so I think it's going to be a great year for authID in 2022.
I'll look forward to following the company's progress. Tom, thanks so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much for having me, Christine.